Hello, children. Okay, now let us sum up this lesson, economics chapter number 2, people as resource. We have come to the end point of the chapter. So till now we have learned about people as a resource and how it can be advantageous for a country. Then we have learned about the economic activities and non-economic activities, three sectors, primary, secondary and tertiary. Now we are going to deal with unemployment. Unemployment. Okay, what is an unemployment? Unemployment is said to exist when people who are willing to work at the going wages cannot find jobs. What is an unemployment? When people are willing to work, they are educated, but when they do not get a job, being educated, they do not get job. Then this situation is called unemployment. बंदा सीखा पढ़ा लिखा है सब कुछ है लेकिन उसको जॉब ही नहीं मिल पा रही है. Then he, this kind of a person is counted under unemployment. The workforce population includes people from 15 years to 59 years age. So what is workforce population? Workforce population means a population which can work and earn money out of the services provided by him or her. So this workforce population starts from the age of 15 years till 59 years of age. Okay. Now current scenario of unemployment in India, that is 2020. So this is a current situation which is not there in the textbook. It is just a part of GK. You can take it. What is going on right now is the COVID-19 situation or pandemic situation, we can call. Because of this, unemployment has increased in India. So let us study the current situation of unemployment in India, that is 2020. India's unemployment rate rose to 7.78% in February, the highest since October 2019 and up from 7.16% in January, according to data released by the Center for Monitoring Indian Economy on Monday, reflecting the impact of a slowdown in the economy. Of course, if people are not allowed to come out of their houses, they cannot go and do their do their jobs and services and whatever. So it is going to impact the unemployment situation in the country. So naturally, it is going to raise the percentage is going to raise. Right. Now this was India. Now let us study about USA. The report showed that 3.28 million Americans filed for unemployment benefits. According to a Federal Reserve estimate, the coronavirus economic freeze could cost 47 million jobs and send the unemployment rate to 32%. 49% companies are considering layoffs. Layoffs means मजदूरों को काम से निकाल देना या उनको जॉब से निकाल देना. सो 49% कंपनीज हैव ऑलरेडी स्टार्टेड लेइंग ऑफ फ्रॉम द कंपनीज इन यूएसए. ओके, नाउ लेट अस कम टू द पॉइंट वी आर गोइंग टू डील विद अनएम्प्लॉयमेंट. अनएम्प्लॉयमेंट मीनिंग वी हैव डन, वी हैव लर्न अबाउट इट. नाउ लेट अस सी द नेचर ऑफ अनएम्प्लॉयमेंट. सो अनएम्प्लॉयमेंट इन रूरल एरिया एंड अनएम्प्लॉयमेंट इन अर्बन एरिया. लेट अस डील सी द क्लासिफिकेशन फर्स्ट एंड देन विल गो इंडिविजुअली. ओके, सो इन रूरल एरिया अनएम्प्लॉयमेंट इज डिसगाइज्ड अनएम्प्लॉयमेंट एंड सीजनल अनएम्प्लॉयमेंट. एंड इन अर्बन एरिया इट इज एजुकेटेड unemployment. It is also disguised as well as seasonal unemployment. So in rural there is only disguised and seasonal, but in urban it is educated, seasonal and disguised unemployment. Well, what is this disguised seasonal and educated unemployment? Let us find out. Seasonal unemployment. People are not able to find jobs during some months of the year. Seasonal, naam se hi pata chalta hai ki साल का कुछ वक्त ये लोग ऐसे ही बैठे रहते हैं, इनको कोई एम्प्लॉयमेंट होता नहीं है. ओके, व्हेन डिमांड फॉर लेबर इज लोअर देन यूजुअल, व्हेन एनी एक्टिविटी डजंट नीड मच लेबर एट दैट टाइम द एंटरप्रेन्योर और द ओनर और द प्रोड्यूसर ऑफ दैट एक्टिविटी ही डिसाइड्स टू remove some people from the job. Okay, so that period is known as slack season. and this slack season can be observed in agricultural sector. It is usually faced by agricultural sector. It leads to migration of workers to towns and big cities. So people, when the seasonal unemployment is there, people cannot sit idle in their houses because no one is going to come and feed them. They have to earn money for their family, right? So when seasonal unemployment takes place, people, they migrate from towns, from villages to towns and big cities. यही समय होता है जब गांव से बहुत सारे लोग काम ढूंढने के लिए शहरों में, बड़े बड़े शहरों में आते हैं. So this is seasonal employment, right? And when their slack period is over, they again return to their villages, they do their jobs over there, they earn money out of that. And when the slack period again comes, then they move to city to earn money in that period of time. Okay, so this is seasonal unemployment. Disguised unemployment. Disguised means hidden, छुपा हुआ unemployment, जो दिखाई नहीं देता है या observation में नहीं आता है. So what are the features of disguised unemployment? It is known as hidden unemployment also. It is found both in rural and urban area. दोनों में ये पाया जाता है, like seasonal unemployment. Mostly in agricultural sector. So where we can find disguised unemployment? In agricultural sector. How in agricultural sector? If suppose in a family of a farmer, there are five people, right? And all those five people are working in another field, okay? दूसरे के farm में ये पांचों लोग काम कर रहे. So if out of these five farmers, three of them are not working, okay, and two of them are working in the farm area, then these three farmers of that family will not get the wages. But sometimes they work, कभी कभी काम करते हैं, कभी कभी नहीं करते हैं, तो कभी 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 नहीं, उनको उनके काम का पैसा मिलता नहीं. They get wages as a family basis, not as a individual basis. So this is called disguised unemployment. दिखने में नहीं आता, लेकिन family के, हम बोलते family के सारे बंदे काम कर रहे हैं, लेकिन सारों में से कितने नहीं कर रहे हैं, कितनों को पैसा नहीं मिल रहा है, right? So this is called disguised unemployment. It is also known as underemployment. It is underemployment भी उसको एक दूसरा नाम है, like hidden employment. So but it has no impact on output. अगर पांच में से तीन कम भी हो गए, लेकिन output पे कोई असर नहीं पड़ने वाला है. So there is no such impact. If I need for my production activity, if I need five people for, okay, if out of those five people, if two or three people are absent and my final product is not going to hamper or it is not going to get affected by the absence of these three workers, then it has no impact on output. उस पर कोई output पर कोई असर होने नहीं वाले, तो मुझे कुछ फर्क नहीं पड़ता, मैं उनको payment करूँ या ना करूँ. So in this way it is disguised unemployment, right? Let us see the examples. Disguised unemployment example. In figure 1, you can see plowing done by 5 people. If out of those 5 people, if 3 people are absent, those two remaining 2 people can carry out their work. They can do the further work. They are able to do the further work without waiting for those 3 people. So those 3 people, they are working or not working, doesn't matter. So this comes under disguised unemployment. Another example, you can see construction work by daily workers. Here there are near about 50 people, I guess they are working under construction site. If out of those 50, 20 people are not present over there, it is not going to affect the final work, right? So those people, whether they get wages or not, doesn't matter. So those 20 people are counted under disguised unemployment. So in figure 1 and figure 2 indicates that more than required people are engaged in farming and service sector. Jitno ki zarurat hai, usse zyada log agar farming or service sector mein kaam karenge, to jitno jo kaam kar raha hai usi bande ko milega, jitno ki zarurat nahi hai wo khali aake kaam karega aur chala jayega. उसको पेमेंट तो मिलेगा नहीं. देन दिस कम्स अंडर डिसगाइज्ड अनएम्प्लॉयमेंट. ओके, नाउ अनदर इज एजुकेटेड अनएम्प्लॉयमेंट, वेयर इट इज ऑब्जर्व्ड इन अर्बन एरिया ओनली. इट इज अ कॉमन फीचर ऑफ अर्बन एरियाज. मेनी यूथ विद मैट्रिकुलेशन, ग्रेजुएशन एंड पोस्ट ग्रेजुएशन डिग्रीज आर नॉट एबल टू फाइंड जॉब्स. सो बहुत सारे ऐसे यूथ है इंडिया में दोज हुआर मैट्रिकुलेटेड और मैट्रिक पास यानी 10वीं पास ग्रेजुएशन दे आर ग्रेजुएटेड एंड दे आर पोस्ट ग्रेजुएटेड ऑल्सो दे आर नॉट एबल टू फाइंड जॉब्स फॉर देम सेल्फ दे आर एजुकेटेड बट नॉट एबल टू फाइंड जॉब्स फॉर देम सेल्फ सो देर इज अनएम्प्लॉयमेंट अमंग टेक्निकली क्वालिफाइड पर्सन ऑन वन हैंड वेल देर इज अ डर्थ ऑफ टेक्निकल स्किल्स रिक्वायर्ड फॉर इकोनॉमिक ग्रोथ On the one hand, we have technically qualified people, but they are not getting proper jobs. And on the other hand, we are desperately in need of these technically qualified people for certain jobs. देखो कैसा ये आयरनी है कि ज़रूरत है लेकिन दे नहीं पा रहे हैं या जानबूझ के इग्नोर कर रहे हैं. So जो बंदे educated है, qualified है, skilled है, जो काम कर सकते हैं So they are not getting jobs and on the other hand there is a need of such people for their productivity but they are not hiring they are not able to hire they are not on one hand these people are not able to find jobs for themselves on the other hand these people are not able to employ good skilled people so yahan pe agar balance ban jaye to educated unemployment छू हो जाएगा कंट्री से सो वी नीड टू स्टडी एवरीथिंग इन डिटेल दोज हु आर एजुकेटेड दे ऑल्सो एंड दोज हु आर प्रोवाइडिंग सर्विसेज फॉर दीज काइंड ऑफ पीपल दे ऑल्सो थिंक उनको कहाँ से कौन से एरिया से कैसे लोग हायर करने हैं जॉब्स के लिए ऑन बोथ द वेज डीप थिंकिंग शुड बी डन economic activities okay we have dealt with this already I'll just read it out for you economic activities according to RAIC economic activity is the production distribution and consumption of commodities these are performed for money economic activities add value to the national income economic activities performed in the country can be calculated measurement remember For example, a shopkeeper selling the goods a farmer growing crops and sells the surplus output etc So, economic activities can be classified primary under primary, secondary, and tertiary sector. This part we have dealt already. Now, let us look after market activities and non-market activities. These are also economic activities. Market activities involve remuneration to anyone who performs. फॉर दैट इज़ एक्टिविटी परफॉर्म फॉर पे और प्रॉफिट ऐसी एक्टिविटी जिससे आपको पे मिले या प्रॉफिट मिले उस एक्टिविटी को बोलते हैं मार्केट एक्टिविटी दीज एक्टिविटीज इंक्लूड प्रोडक्शन ऑफ गुड्स और सर्विसेज इंक्लूडिंग गवर्नमेंट सर्विस प्रोडक्शन ऑफ गुड्स देन प्रोवाइडिंग सर्विसेज इंक्लूडिंग गवर्नमेंट सर्विसेज आर काउंटेड अंडर मार्केट एक्टिविटी गवर्नमेंट सर्विस क्या है वो सर्विस करने से पैसे ही तो मिलते हैं तो वो सर्विसेज भी आते हैं मार्केट एक्टिविटी में राइट सो इट एड्स वैल्यू टू द नेशनल इनकम एनी एक्टिविटी विच एड्स वैल्यू टू नेशनल इनकम गवर्नमेंट को जितना ज़्यादा पैसा होता है सरकार को जितना ज़्यादा मुनाफा होता है समझो देश को भी मुनाफा होता है सो सच एक्टिविटीज विच आर कॉन्ट्रीब्यूटिंग टू द बेनिफिट ऑफ द कंट्री एट द बॉटम सो वी दोज एक्टिविटीज आर कॉल्ड मार्केट एक्टिविटीज क्लियर For example, a farmer producing rice and selling in a vegetable mandi or a teacher working in a school can be counted under market activities. Market activities can be taken as manufacturing of cars. Jitne bhi factories, industries, primary sector, secondary sector, tertiary sector mein jitne bhi activities hai, jisse paisa milta ho, that comes under market activity, right? Another examples I have given market activities like your cafe, market, bookshop, candy shop, cloth shop, computer shop, DVD rental, music shop, bakery, green grocers, pet shop, mall, restaurants, blah blah blah, etc. All these shops are there. They earn money after selling the final product. So they are earning money. So it is market activity. Market activity here is production of crops farmer. We have dealt already with this example. Now let us deal with non-market activities. Non-market activities are the production for self-consumption. जो खुद के लिए प्रोड्यूस किया जा रहा है, खुद के कंजम्पशन के लिए प्रोड्यूस किया जा रहा है, सच एन एक्टिविटी इज नोन एज नॉन मार्केट एक्टिविटी. जो मार्केट में जाके बेचना नहीं है, मुझे मेरे लिए बनाना है, खाना है या कुछ भी पहनना है, कुछ भी करूँ मैं, जो मैं मेरे लिए कर रही हूँ, दैट कम्स अंडर नॉन मार्केट एक्टिविटी. दिस कैन बी कंजम्पशन एंड प्रोसेसिंग ऑफ प्राइमरी प्रोडक्ट एंड ओन अकाउंट प्रोडक्शन ऑफ फिक्स्ड एसेट्स. इट डज नॉट एड वैल्यू टू द नेशनल इनकम. नॉन मार्केट एक्टिविटी वैल्यू एड नहीं करता है नेशनल इनकम के लिए. राइट, इफ़ आई एम एबल टू स्टिच क्लॉथ्स फॉर माई सेल्फ, ओके, एक अच्छी सी कुर्ती में मेरे लिए स्टिच कर सकती हूँ. सो वट आई हैव टू डू, आई हैव टू इन्वेस्ट मनी इन बाइंग द क्लॉथ फॉर माई कुर्ती, ओके. देन आई नीड मनी टू बाय सीविंग मशीन, राइट. सो इफ़ आई हैव द स्किल टू स्टिच प्रॉपर ड्रेस फॉर माई सेल्फ, ओके, हियर आई हैव इन्वेस्टेड मनी, बट द फाइनल प्रोडक्ट विल बी कंज्यूम्ड बाई मी. उसका यूज़ मैं करने वाली हूँ, मैं बेचने वाली नहीं हूँ. सो तो जो काम मैं मेरे खुद के लिए कर रही हूँ, सो वाई कंट्री इज़ गोइंग टू बेनिफिट आउट ऑफ इट? नो. सो इट डज नॉट एड एनी वैल्यू टू द नेशनल इनकम. इट इज़ नॉट डन फॉर प्रॉफिट. मैं मेरे लिए कुर्ती सी रही हूँ, इसमें क्या प्रॉफिट है? कुछ प्रॉफिट नहीं है यार. मैं मेरे लिए खाना पकाती हूँ, इसमें क्या प्रॉफिट है? नो, देयर इज नो प्रॉफिट. सो व्हाट इज दिस? सी दैट थिंग आई एम डूइंग फॉर माई सेल्फ, ओके. प्रॉफिट ऐसे सेंस में हो सकता है कि मैं मेरा पैसा बचा रही हूँ, बट एक्स्ट्रा प्रॉफिट हो रहा है? नो, इट इज़ नॉट डन फॉर प्रॉफिट, बट इट इज़ डन फॉर सेल्फ सेटिस्फैक्शन, खुद की कंटेंटमेंट के लिए मैं करती हूँ. इट्स लाइक दैट, ओके. सो नॉन मार्केट एक्टिविटी एग्जाम्पल कुकिंग बाय होम मेकर, आपकी मम्मी इसमें आती है नॉन मार्केट एक्टिविटी में. शी इज़ कुकिंग फॉर यू, शी इज़ वर्किंग फॉर यू इन द हाउस फॉर 24 hours, शी इज़ स्ट्राइविंग हार्ड फॉर यू पीपल. डज शी डिमांड मनी फॉर दैट? No, she never demands money for that. And because of her household work, she is not adding any value to the national income. She is not doing it for her own profit. उसके खुद के profit के लिए थोड़ी ना काम करती है घर में, आप लोगों के लिए करती है काम. So she is doing it she is doing it selflessly, है ना? Selfishly नहीं, selflessly कर रही है वो खुद आपके लिए. So she is not demanding any money. So it come, her activities come under non-market activity. Okay. Some more examples of non-market activity: teaching done by a family member, gardening, right? Okay. Now, story of Sakal. Now, these are the images taken from your textbook as well. Also, so story of Sakal. There were two friends, Vilas and Sakal, living in the same village, Simapur. Sakal was a 12-year-old boy. His mother, Sheila, looked after domestic chores. His father, Bhuta Chaudhary, worked in an agricultural field. Sakal helped his mother in domestic chores. He also looked after his younger brother Jitu and sister Situ. His uncle Shyam had passed the matriculation examination but was sitting idle in the house as he had no jobs. Bhuta and Sheila were eager to teach Sakal. They forced him to join the village school which he soon joined. He started studying and completed his higher secondary examination. His father persuaded him to continue his education. He raised a loan for Sakal to study a vocational course in computers. Sakal was meritorious and interested in studies from the beginning. With great vigor and enthusiasm, he completed his course. After some time, he got a job in a private firm. He even designed a new kind of software. This software helped him increase the sale of the firm. His boss acknowledged his services and rewarded him with a promotion. Now, why I read this story for you? Because you people are going to tell me, among the family members of Sakal, how many members are involved in market activity and how many members are involved in non-market activities. So सकल की फैमिली में कौन कौन है, उसकी मम्मी शीला, उसकी उसके पिताजी his father बूटा चौधरी, his sister सीतू, younger brother जीतू, uncle's name या श्याम. इन में से कौन से बंदे non-market activity में आते हैं और कौन से बंदे market activity में आते हैं. I'll give you 1 minute time. Just think and tell me. Then I'll going to move on to this next slide, which has the answer for it. You can pause the video if you want. Okay. So let us see. Market activities in Sakal's family is done by Bhuta. Means his father and Sakal himself, because Bhuta was the farmer and he earned money by selling crops from his farm area, right? And Sakal, he got educated and he started doing service and he earned out of that. So dono insaan paise kama ke laate hai ghar mein, so their activities are involved under market activity. And non market activities are done by Sheila, his mother. She is housewife. Okay, Jitu and Situ, his younger brother and sister, they are not properly educated and they are doing nothing. So they come under non market activity. And Shyam, his uncle, who is matriculated, जो दसवीं पास है, but he is sitting idle in the house. घर में ऐसे ही बैठे रहता है, वो कुछ काम करता नहीं. So he comes under non-market activity. Understood? Now I hope you people have understood this chapter in detail and we have come to an end of this chapter. So please, please, please watch all the videos, all the three videos again and again until you people get the concepts clear. And it's easy to understand, I guess. People as resource, economic activities, non-economic activities, market activities, non-market activities, and unemployment and types of unemployment. In short, I have told you all the things which I have explained you in these videos. So you people are going to watch these videos in detail, mark important points in the refresher and the textbook as well. Please highlighter use करो भैया, ये मत pencil से mark मत करो, समझ में नहीं आता है अब जो PDF भेजते हो. So mark important points in your textbook as well as a refresher and leave your comments in the comment section. And if you have any difficulty, please message me personally or call me personally. I'll help you out. Okay, so bye for now. Bye.